Good morning, students, and welcome back. So, in the previous class, yesterday, we discussed about the oogenesis, that is the formation of a ovum or a egg. So, that is a female gamete. Okay, and today we will discuss about the structure of a sperm. Okay, the structure of a sperm. In the previous class, we have discussed while discussing the gametogenesis, that is the formation of gametes. In that, we are having two types of gametes, male gamete and the female gamete, isn't it? And the male gametes are sperms, and the formation of the sperms or these male gametes is known as spermatogenesis. We have studied the spermatogenesis, that is the formation of the sperms, okay, in detail. And let us today discuss about the structure of those sperms or the male gametes. Fine, okay. So the sperm is mainly it contains four parts. Okay, that is the first thing is that this sperm is microscopic in nature. Sperm is a microscopic, that means that it is very small, which cannot be seen with the naked eyes or bare eyes. Okay, so they are microscopic in nature, and they composed of four parts, that is a head, neck, and middle piece and tail. So a sperm contains four parts, that is a head, neck, middle piece and finally tail. You see, this is the structure of a sperm. Diagram of a sperm, and very much important even from the point of view of exams. You will be asked in the exam to draw a neat labeled diagram of a sperm. So this is the diagram and the structure of the sperm, and let us get familiar with the different parts of the sperm. Fine. So as I told, this sperm contains four parts. You see, from here to here, this part, this whole part up to here, it is a head. Okay, and you see this portion, the one which is having a groove here, idu again after that, this part is a neck. And after this neck, you see, from here to here, up to here, okay, from here up to here, this part is a middle piece. So this is head, this is neck, so this is neck, and this part from neck up to here, it is a middle piece. And from after this middle piece, you see, this is the last structure. You can easily guess, it is a tail. Tail like structure, that is the tail only. Okay, so this part is a tail. Okay, so sperm is microscopic in nature, and it contains a head, neck, middle piece and a tail. Okay, fine. Further, let us discuss still more things about the sperm. And the whole body of sperm is covered by plasma membrane. Plasma membrane. So you see, the whole body of the sperm is covered or enveloped, it is enveloped or covered, surrounded by plasma membrane. You see, this last outer part, that is a basic plasma membrane, this one, the last the covering, envelope, surrounding one is nothing but the plasma membrane. Okay, and next, the head, this head, this is head, this whole portion, and this head contains an elongated nucleus. Okay, so this head, it contains, you see, this is nucleus which is elongated. So the head contains an elongated nucleus, and anterior to this nucleus, you see here, anterior and posterior. Anterior andra mumbaga, posterior andra himbaga. So anterior to this elongated nucleus, there is a cap-like structure. You see this, the shaded part. I have shaded, na? Getting my point? So this is a cap-like structure, and that is anterior to the this elongated nucleus. This shaded part, that is known as the acrosome. Okay, so this acrosome, it contains this acrosome, that is a cap-like structure above the haploid nucleus. It is filled with enzymes. This acrosome is filled with the enzymes, and these enzymes are very much essential for fertilization. Okay, with ovum or egg. Okay, and the next thing is that was about the head. Then this middle piece, it contains numerous mitochondria. So the middle piece, it contains numerous means many mitochondria. As you know, as you have already studied in the previous year, mitochondria is a powerhouse of a cell because it produces energy. So that is the function here. So this middle piece, it is having a numerous, you see, these are the mitochondria. You see this, and I have already marked. This is a mitochondria which are present in the middle piece, and these mitochondria, they produce energy. These mitochondria, they produce energy, and this energy is very much essential for the movement of this tail movement, and thereby it provides motility of the sperm, and that is very much essential for the fertilization. Okay, and next thing is that the woman's ejaculate, the humans, they ejaculate. The male, the human male, they ejaculate means release 200 to 300 millions of sperms. So a human male release 200 to 300 millions of sperms per coitus, that means per intercourse, having sexual act. So a human male ejaculate or release 200 to 300 of this sperms per coitus, that is a intercourse. Okay, that is sexual act. And for a normal fertility, fertility antandra phalvatate antandra a man able to give, an individual able to give the child, adakke now fertility anta helthe. ಫಲವತ್ತತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಎ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆನ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಫಲವತ್ತಾಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು, ಒಂದು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಹೆರುವಂತ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ 200 to 300 million ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್ 60% should have a normal shape and size. Out of this 200 to 300 million sperms produced per coitus or per intercourse, out of this minimum 60% of the sperm should have a normal shape and size so that an individual can be fertile or an individual can say to be a fertile. And 40% of these sperms should have vigorous motility. Vigorous means high speed. Motility means movement. So, out of 200 to 300 million sperms produced by a male woman per coitus, out of them 60% should have normal shape and size and 40% should have this vigorous motility so that an individual will be fertile, normal fertile. Okay, that means he can able to give birth to the child. Okay, so that is one thing. And so next, after this release of this sperms from the which are produced in the seminiferous tubules, they will enter into this accessory ducts. Okay, so the function of this accessory ducts, through these accessory ducts the sperms are moved out of the male body and deposited into the female genital tract. Okay, so maintenance of these accessory duct, okay, that is vasa deferens, retitestis, okay, and vas deferens, okay, and the epididymis. So the maintenance of accessory ducts and that of glands is taken care by the testicular hormone, that is androgens. Okay, so and the secretions of this vas deferens and epididymis and that of seminal vesicle, they constitute the semen. Okay, the secretion of these accessory ducts and that of glands, that is seminal vesicle and prostate and bulbourethral glands, all these secretions along with sperms, that is known as semen. Okay, and maintenance of these accessory duct and that of seminal vesicle glands is taken care by the testicular hormone, that is androgens. Okay, so this is about the structure of sperm. Okay, and we will conclude here. And we will discuss about the menstrual cycle in the next class. Okay, so thank you.